So this is another one of the series of short videos on some little clinical tip that we feel is important. This one might be a little longer than some, and we're going to talk about dentin conservation, which I think is kind of a important modern tenet of endodontic therapy. We used to talk about the triad of cleaning, shaping, and obturation, and I really think that has to have a fourth leg as far as dentin structural integrity. So this requires actually a little bit more time, and it's a little harder to do in our office. But this is what I like to see these days. This would be pretty much the biggest access I would like to do, where the pulp horns are preserved, and we're not taking away any more dentin than we need to. And this probably could have been a little smaller still, but this would be about the biggest we want to go. The old idea of being straight line access and going straight up from the pulp horns is really not where modern endodontic therapy is or should be, because we've all had the frustration of seeing root canal treated teeth come back with vertical root fractures, and we really need to be focused on doing everything we can to avoid that. So this is another example of just kind of using what we have and preserving what dentin we can in the middle of the tooth. So this we accessed more from the mesial. We really didn't need to unroof this to have really good access into all these canals and do our job of cleaning and shaping. And once again, we like to be somewhat opportunistic in our access. And it's nice when we get cases actually as we're just starting out rather than retreatments, because now we can preserve a lot of this dentin by using the existing decay to get into where we need to go. And then we can flow our buildup into this area, and we preserve all of this dentin here and all of this dentin here, which offers a lot more structural integrity from those buccal lingual forces that we get. So once again, the whole idea of straight line access where we would remove all this so that we could get to this curve really, I think, is maybe winning the battle but losing the war of tooth retention. So we can actually leave that pulp horn in place. That's a pulp horn there. And with our flexible instruments, we can still get where we need to go and do our job. And this is the way that patient left, with all of this dentin here tying together the buccal and lingual of this tooth. I believe this tooth has a much better chance of being there for a lifetime. So a couple of things are required to do this. You need high magnification, like 7x or better. And if we're going to use rotary, it's important to have heat-treated instruments that you can bend and get into this area. So we're using the mesial decay here, and we really haven't unroofed too much of the distal portion of this tooth because we have the mesial decay, but it's hard to get our instruments in there. So we need to kind of pre-bend them. So we're coming in through here. It's kind of hard to pick up on this slide here, but this nickel titanium heat-treated instrument is bent, so it will go in the distal. Here you can see it a little bit better bending this way. And this one comes down, you can see it starting to torque toward the buccal, and here on the mirror you can see it torquing and heading into that distal buccal canal that we would not have been able to get to. Same thing here, so that we're kind of using this advantage of the newer instruments to snake it into these areas that we wouldn't be able to get to before. And this is how that patient left. And again, this whole area of dentin here is preserved, and I think that's important. So if we have our CT, we know what we're dealing with. We can start off with a small access and then get into the canals where we know them to be without having to unroof searching for things that may or may not be there. And one more thing that we do sometimes, not very often, but if we have a pulp chamber that's very wide mesial distally, we can sometimes leave a little dentin in the middle and still do our job of cleaning and shaping. And then we can flow the buildup underneath this truss of dentin to the distal, and we cure that. And this is the way the buildup looks. And then this is the way the patient leaves when we've done a trust access. And you can see how, again, this ties the buccal and lingual of that tooth together. And we know that's where we put our most force when we're chewing or when we have parafunctional habits. So I went through this kind of quick, but I hate to make these videos too long. But this is all about preserving what matters. And I can't tell you how many times someone has sat in my chair or a dentist has called me and said, hey, be careful of my new crown. And, you know, that's good. We certainly want to do that. But I don't know that anyone has ever sat in my chair and said, hey, be careful of my natural tooth structure. But that's really what we want to be about. And I really believe the more we preserve that, the longer these teeth are going to be retained. And that's really the ultimate goal of endodontic therapy. not a pretty white stripe on the x-ray, but someone having a tooth there that they can chew on with confidence for a very long time. So I hope you enjoyed this.